Hey guys, in today's video we're going to be talking about the interquartile range, or IQR. If you want to learn what it is and what it is used for, how to calculate it, and how to use it to identify outliers, this is the video for you. Let's try and understand what the interquartile range actually is. And to do so, we need to divide our data set, which should be sorted, very importantly, into four quartiles, each containing 25% of the data. Now, IQR is defined as the difference between the medians of the second and the first halves of the set, which would be Q3 and Q1. When you subtract the first quartile from the third, that leaves you with the middle 50%. And what IQR does, its purpose is to show the spread between the 25th and the 75th percentage of the data. And that is useful because IQR is a trimmed estimator. We trimmed off some of the data, we trimmed off all of the extreme values, to leave the ones closer to the median, which would give us a more robust measure of scale. Let's move on to more practical matters. And of course, the question all of you have is how to calculate the IQR. We'll start by looking at a data set that contains an even amount of items. And the procedure will be slightly different from a data set that has an odd number of items in it. So let's get started. And of course, as I've mentioned before, to calculate the IQR, we need the data set to be sorted. So that's step number one. If we sort this range, we get something like this. And once we have it sorted, we have to find the median. In this case, since there is an even number of items, the median will be the mean of the two central numbers, 5 and 9 in our case, and that gives us 7. Now, once we know the median, we are actually going to calculate quartile number 1 and quartile number 3, and for that, we are going to split the data set into two halves, one that ends with 5 and the other that starts with the 9. And we're again going to get to the middle, and we have in both cases two numbers in the middle. So again, we have to add them and then divide them by 2 to find the mean of those numbers. In first case, we have 4. In the second case, we have 11. So we have quartile number 1, quartile number 3, and guess what? We finally calculate IQR, and IQR equals to 7. That's just about it for the even data set. Now let's take a look at the odd data set. Here we have 7 numbers, and the first step remains the same. We sort the data, and we get a set that looks like this in ascending order. And you know, the next step, it's still the same as well. We find the median. In this case, the median is just one number, so no need to calculate the mean. And if we try to calculate from both sides, I mean, if we try to count from both sides, we see that it's number 7. That leaves 3 items in the first half and 3 items in the second half. And the difference here is that with the odd data set, there's two methods, essentially. You have the exclusive method and the inclusive method. With the inclusive method, I believe you would leave the 7 as the last item in the first half and as the first item in the second half. However, I'm more familiar with the exclusive method, where you simply disregard the median, or 7 in our case, and you proceed to calculate Q1 and Q3 by finding the middle of those 3 numbers on each half. And in the case of quartile number 1, it's going to be number 4. And in quartile number 3, it's going to be number 10. So now that you found the median of both halves, You are, of course, going to subtract, and that gives you the IQR of 6. So if we compare the two data set, the spread would be higher, actually, in the first data set as compared to the second one. Last but not least, identifying outliers. Here we have a box plot with the median, quartiles 1 and 3, and from each quartile there extends a whisker, which is of the length 1.5 times the IQR. So it's Q1 minus 1.5 IQR and Q3 plus 1.5 IQR. It is normally accepted that everything that falls outside of those two whiskers, every data point that's outside of this range, is an outlier. And we can use that mathematically to calculate where the outliers are in our data set. And for that, let's go back to our first even data set that we calculated the IQR for. We've established that our IQR is 7, so 1.5 times 7 is 10.5, and Q1 minus 1.5 IQR is 6.5, whereas Q3 plus 1.5 IQR gives us the value of 21.5. So thus, 6.5 is the lower bound for an outlier, whereas 21.5 is the upper bound for our outliers. Now you can see that there's nothing that falls below 2 in our data set. However, there's number 30, which quite clearly is outside of the upper bound of our data set, and that's how we identify it as an outlier. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you found this video useful. Do not forget to check out other videos in our channel and give us your feedback in the comments section below.